Murders have been increasing in the Windy City for two straight years, and according to the Chicago police, 3,411 shootings occurred in 2021 as of early December, marking a 9% increase from last year. And earlier this week, Chicago Mayor Lori Lightfoot called for federal help to fight violent crime.
That's why I have formally asked the Attorney General of the United States, Merrick Garland, to, with all deliberate haste, detail ATF agents to Chicago for 6 months so that we can increase the number of gun investigations and seizures in Chicago.
So Lightfoot wants help from the Biden administration, but she didn't want it from the Trump administration. And in addition to that, violent crimes are going up and arrests are going down. Now, here to discuss is New York Times bestselling author, National Radio Hall of Famer, and host of the Savage Nation podcast, Michael Savage. Dr. Savage, thanks for being with us here on this Christmas. Now, I want you to take a look at this, and we're going to leave it up for the rest of the segment. These are the names of the over 750 people who were murdered in the city of Chicago. What are we to make of crime when we look at this?
You know, it's not that complicated. First of all, thanks for having me, Logan. Crime and punishment, they go together like a horse and carriage. Reduce the punishment, crime goes up. Handcuff the police, crime goes up. Solution, more harsh punishments, number one. And I know this is going to, it's like, great, build more prisons. We don't need less jails. This is an experiment, Logan, that the liberals have pushed upon us. Release them from prison, give them benefits, give them the benefit of the doubt, let them rejoin society, and suddenly they're all going to act like altar boys. They're going to be wonderful altar boys. Well, no, the opposite is true. You release them on the streets and you have murders, you have robberies, you have smash and grabs. Logan, can I read something to you from my 2005 book, Liberalism is a Mental Disorder? Make believe it's a fireside chat. It goes like this. Remember, this was written in 05, Logan, and it's called The Head of the Snake, the ACLU, because everything happens for a reason. It's the ACLU behind all of this. Here's what I wrote. This decade is a graveyard for politicians whose thinking was molded by the myth of the 60s. The myth of the 60s. Liberals like to portray their desire for continuous social revolution dressed as a noble enterprise. Wearing this clothing does not diminish the evil and danger unleashed by 40 years of trolling down the blind alleys of progressive politics. And the people are starting to see the lie. That was in 2005. Has anything changed? It's gotten worse. For a brief window, we had a little movement to the center under Donald Trump. But I must say, Logan, and this is not going to be popular, when he brought in Kim Kardashian and Kanye West into the White House, and Kanye West threw his shoes up on the great desk of the presidency, I was outraged. And I'll tell you, I said so. I was not liked by criticizing President Trump at that time. That was the greatest mistake Trump made, was listening to those two leftists telling him to introduce prison reform. Remember that? People have forgotten it. Trump introduced prison reform, and we don't want to remember that. He made a grave error there. And the fact of the matter is, it was because of Kim Kardashian, a waste of human DNA, and Kanye West with his feet up on the desk. They are the principal reason that we started to move in the wrong direction.
Hey, I'm Rob Finnerty. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please join the conversation in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, too. Hit the bell icon to be alerted to breaking news. And remember, there's a whole lot more on Newsmax TV, America's fastest growing cable news network. Newsmax TV, where real news for real people.